Another experiment in analog IC applications is a comparator using op-amp. So in applications of op-amp, we're having a zero level detector, nothing but so whether the input signal has crossed that zero level or not, it is used to compare. So if you observe the diagram, so for third pin, which is a non-inverting input, we used to apply any input signal, and the other, which is a second pin, which is inverting pin, we used to give some reference voltage, V reference. It might be zero or some other voltage levels. And this is at pin 6, we used to find the output, and minus 15 volts at pin 4 and plus 15 volts at pin 7. So the output of this particular circuit will be a square wave irrespective of the type of input signal what we apply. It might be either a sine or triangle or anything. So the output voltage will be in terms of a square waveform for a comparator circuit. Now, so let us see how this circuit works. So as you see, I have connected an op-amp IC741 here, and I'm connecting pin 2, which is an inverting terminal, to ground. Now for pin 3, we used to connect a triangular waveform here. So with the help of function generator, I have taken triangular signal and the positive of this triangular signal is connected to pin 3 of op-amp, and the remaining connections what we are left with is, so one is supply voltage plus 15 to pin 7 of op-amp and minus 15 to be connected to pin 4 of op-amp, and a ground of plus or minus 15 volts connected to ground. So this completes the supply connections, and the CRO, the input signal ground wire, is connected to ground. Now channel 1 CRO probe is connected at the output, so which is pin 6, and to compare the input signal and output signals, I am again connecting second channel CRO probe to the input signal, which is at pin 3 of op-amp. So this is how the circuit gets constructed. So this circuit actually compares the input signal with the reference level 0. So for this circuit, we have not applied any reference voltage. It compares the input signal applied at a non-inverting input with the other input signal, which is V reference, which is 0 volts. And by comparing these two input signals, the output generated by op-amp will be a square waveform, like plus or minus VC sat will be generated in the form of a square wave. Let us see the output. I am just turning on the gate by applying a triangular waveform signal. So this is the input triangular waveform signal. Now the output of this circuit can be observed by turning this kit on, and you can see, so the output generated for this comparator circuit is actually a square wave. So irrespective of the input type of signal, so the comparator circuit generates a square wave signal. So for example, let us change the signal, input signal here. I'm just giving a square signal now. So for square signal also, the output generated is a square wave, and for a sinusoidal signal also, the output generated is a square wave. So comparator circuit produces a square waveform irrespective of the type of input signal applied, and for this circuit, the reference voltage applied is 0 volts. So now for the same circuit, I am applying a reference voltage of So let us say 1 volt. So let us say 1 volt, and let us see how the shape of the output waveform signal just changes. See, as the reference signal is increased, the shape of the signal is changing. So based on the reference level what we give, so anyhow we are going to get a square waveform as a comparator output, and depending on the reference signal given at the other input signal, so the output will be generated. So this is an experiment of comparators using op-amp.